So welcome everyone to our second day of this, or rather maybe a third day of this Finnish Open Science event, and to the Nordic workshop on data citation policies and practices, how to make it happen. And I am Pekka Orponen, and I'm chairing this event. My regular job is as a professor of computer science at Aalto University, but I'm mostly here in the capacity of the chairman of the Finnish Committee on Research Data. And let me first say a few promotional words about the Finnish Committee on Research Data so you know where we are coming from. So, okay, I can't quite see my own slide. So the Council of Finnish Academies, or in Finnish better known as Tiedeakatemian neuvottelukunta, or TANK, hosts a network of 35 so-called national committees which represent their respective fields of science in international scientific organizations. And in particular, so these committees, there are committees on physics and ocean research and climate and atmospheric studies and many, many things. This has a long history, about 100 years of history, if I recall correctly. So in particular, they provide the Finnish representation of their areas in the International Council for Science, or ICSU, as it is known. And now this Finnish Committee for Research Data, this is the most recent member of this happy family. It was established by a TANK decision in June 2015. And so we are sort of the Finnish representatives to ICSU, and within ICSU these research data issues are coordinated by the so-called Committee on Data for Science and Technology, or CODATA, and so this FCRD, or Finnish Committee of Research Data, represents Finland at this CODATA. Okay. So the purpose is to promote the principles of open data and open science in Finland, and to advance the effective use of research data and good practices in data management. It's a rather small group, so there is not much kind of administrative clout. We are just kind of an advisory team. So I'm the current chairman. Kirsi Vainio-Korhonen, who is a professor of Finnish history at University of Turku, is the vice chair. Is Kirsi here? No, I don't think she is. Leif Laaksonen, who I think many of you know from this data contact, who is the director at the Finnish IT Center for Science, CSC, is one member. Leif is not here, but he was yesterday. Petri Myllymäki, who is professor of computer science at the University of Helsinki and director of Helsinki Institute of Information Technology, HEAT, is one of our members. Petri is there. And Jussi Nuorteva, who is the Director General of the National Archives of Finland, is not here, but is a member. And Sanna Sorvari, who is from the Finnish Meteorological Institute, and is also represents Finland at the World Data Systems, which is another sub-council of ICSU. Okay. So anyway, Heidi Laine is the secretary. Heidi is actually running her own parallel workshop on citizen science at the time, so she is not here, but I think she will be here in the afternoon. Okay, so what's the purpose of the present event? So to increase the awareness about the important concept of data citation and the emerging ecosystem supporting it, and discuss the concrete actions needed to make these data citations a part of everyday research practice, hopefully in Finland and the other Nordic countries. So somehow assess what is this concept or framework, where are we now, where would we want to go, and how do we get there. Okay, so there will be many expert presentations on various issues. What is data citation, and what are the various aspects of this program. But just as a kind of a brief summary, so I personally think of these data citations as kind of the gold standard of open data, in the sense that they somehow focus a lot of the issues of kind of making open data into a reality. And when you have kind of working data citations, I mean, in order to have working citations, you have to have all the pieces coming together kind of in a good manner. And then this having good data citations will then promote further progress in this area. So to make the application of open research data an integral part of everyday research practice, so data sets must be citable, similarly as research publications are now. So stated like that, there is not much magic to this. I mean, we have a good publication citation culture, so why don't we extend this to data sets? Perfect. And simply put, this data citation is a reference to data for the purpose of credit attribution and facilitation of access to the data. I took this definition from an excellent and at the time comprehensive report called Out of Sight, Out of Mind, kind of nice pun in the title, The Current State of Practice, Policy and Technology for Data Citation, which was compiled by the joint co-data ITSCI, this is another ICSU Council, Internal Council for... Okay, now it's something, the letters are wrong. It should be ICTS, okay, Information Council for Technology and Technological Scientific Information. It's published in the CoData Data Science Journal, volume 12, and it has a lot of kind of a discussion of what is data citation, what are the concepts, and what is needed to get there. So data citations, they are important because they facilitate the reuse of open research data. I mean, you read a paper, you notice a data set cited there, you click on the data citation and you get to the data set and continue from there, so kind of easy access to data. And hence reuse is facilitated. So they provide mechanisms of credit and attribution for contributors to data. So currently we do not have really effective mechanisms for kind of attributing credit to the people who have compiled the data. So the data is somewhere there and there must be the credit goes to the kind of the papers that use the data, but there's no mechanism to kind of credit the data. And of course, the enhanced verifiability and reproducibility of data-intensive research, it's easy to kind of get access to the data set and kind of see if the results have been derived correctly from the data. And they promote good data management practices, because if you want to make your data available, so then you have to somehow kind of curate the data, make sure that everything is in good order. Okay, so if this is so excellent, why are we not there yet? Well, actually, developing this kind of a data citation culture requires quite a bit of infrastructure and changes in culture. And this is just happening, or all of us, I trust, are trying to make this happen. So first of all, you need data infrastructures, you need well-established and easy-to-use repositories where to put the data, and kind of people can find the repositories and they know what to do with their data, and it has to be sufficiently easy. There has to be provisions for persistent storage of the data, so that it's not on the hard drive or the disk of the researcher's laptop, it's a kind of in a well-defined repository and somebody takes care of the data over long term. There may be needs of version control and other technical things. You need access mechanisms to the data. I mean, there needs to be some infrastructure that leads from the click on the paper link to the actual data. This needs kind of a support infrastructure, which is not always there yet. You need to have standards for how you annotate the data, metadata standards. There need be, and there will be opportunities for publishing the data, kind of journals that appreciate and publish data. And this data needs to be integrated in the academic reward system, so they are recognized by the funding agencies and the universities as items of credit. And to be recognized, they need to become some metrics of quality too for the data. And then, as you know, or as we all know, so there is a lot of work to do in the academic research data management citation culture, so to kind of make the researchers do all these things that are kind of expected or needed for this. So making all these changes to happen, so this involves a large number of stakeholders. So we need to be infrastructure providers, libraries, publishers, funding agencies, and policymakers, and the researchers themselves need to be take part in this, making this happen. So this is a very important concept in order to promote open data and open science, but there's a lot of things that need to happen before everything is in place. And so it's an exciting project. Okay. So then to the present event in more detail. So the idea is to become familiar with this concept of data citation, its significance for open science, and the, okay, so technical, political, cultural, I should maybe say infrastructure, policy, and culture developments. So political in the sense of policy. So all of that is needed to make data citations a kind of everyday research practice, similarly as publication citations are now. So that's the kind of one part. One is to somehow be informed of what's the international state of the art and in the development of data citation policies and practices. And we have excellent speakers on that. Then assess the Finnish and Nordic level of preparedness. Where are we now in the international comparison context? And then discuss the actions that are needed by different stakeholders to advance the Finnish and Nordic competencies in this area. Okay, so here is the program once more. So I hope to be done in 2 or 3 minutes. Then we'll have a general presentation from Sarah Callahan, with Sarah is there. So Sarah is the editor-in-chief of this CoData journal, which had published, for instance, this nice or excellent report on data citation. So Sarah will talk about the general things and the CoData perspective. Then there's Jostein Sundet from Nordforsk, who will talk about open science and open data in the Nordic view. Then we have people from the Finnish science, policy, and planning side. So there is Tommy Halonen from the Finnish Ministry of Education and Culture, who will talk about research indicator in the Finnish university funding model. And then we have Anu Nuutinen from the Academy of Finland, who is in charge of research indicators, and or let's say research assessments in the Academy of Finland. Then we go for lunch at next door at restaurant at noon, restaurant Kildakellari, which is right next door, and many of you were there yesterday, and for the other ones I will tell you how to get there. And then after lunch at 1:15 we continue with the kind of the practical side of making data citations work by Andreas Rauber, who is somewhere there in the back. He's the co-chair of the Research Data Alliance working group, now interest group on data citation. Then we have a talk by Tobias Weigel, who is there, on permanent identifiers. So Tobias has been the co-chair of many working groups at the Research Data Alliance, including the interest group on PIDS, you are co-chair of that one. So, and then we have a presentation by Esa-Pekka Keskitalo from the National Library of Finland, and he will talk about the Finnish National PIDs and the National PID Service in Finland. And then we have Ella Bingham from my home university. Ella is not here right now, so Ella is kind of the planning director, so to speak, at the Aalto Strategic Support, and he will give his view of how this whole landscape looks from the kind of the university leadership point of view. And then we have a concluding panel discussion with a few of the speakers and hopefully good interaction about, I mean, where are we really and where do we want to go and how do we get there. And then we hope to conclude by 4. Okay, so that's the scheme, and I think with that I maybe give the floor to Sarah.